morning. Here's a little update. One of my Homoeomma actually molted last night. This is the male. Check the mold again. Certainly a male. Couldn't find any spermatic key at all. And yeah, this is the one that I bought as Pocarima classy, which is actually a H species blue. It looks pretty, really pretty. Now, size before mold was around 3/4 inches or 3.5 inches stretched out. This looks to be around 4 now, something. Maybe even a little bigger. Let me reach for that. He's very skittish anyways, but I just want to get a impression at least there. It's probably going to take a run if I touch him too much, but yeah, I know you don't like that. It looks like 4.5 inches currently. I don't want to touch him too much since, like I said, he's pretty much freshly molted last night. There we go. And you can see he's quite big now, actually. And yeah, kind of wondering this actually is a Thexopelma, but I'm not entirely sure yet. I need to check with some people. Just thought I'd share. And yeah. Next. Hey guys, this is a little update. So my geniculata female finally molted. The molt is right there. And that's her. She looks pretty big now, at least on the carapace. And yeah, she just molted today morning, and it's evening now. So I'm gonna take the mold out. Whoops, sorry. Yeah, I know. All right. At least this is a fully intact mold. It's still pretty wet even. As you can see there. And yeah, she's there. She looks huge. And she's already in her... Yeah. I'm gonna go refill her water dish now and then leave her be. Hopefully that I can get some... measure on her when she has hardened in a few days. But this mold is 4 inches, I think, around. Actually, let me go and get my measuring tape here. But let's see. Yeah, it's like 4 inches. And yeah, I'm guessing she'll be around 5 now when she has hardened and stretched out. All right. I think I got some other updates, but let me finish this up first. All right. All right. Just a second. Alright, so since this has been done, next update would be my ground style pulchropes. And don't know if you can see that actually, but she dug herself in into her hide there. And yeah, I'm guessing there's a mold coming up. Also, Pecambrogia moriko actually started webbing like crazy, so I know that she's in pre-molt anyways. I'm guessing she's preparing for molting as well. Piaminia fedra, currently not out. I rehoused the other one, Furali, which is sitting there. She looks fine. She's just very weird behaving currently. I don't know why, but it's like over 2 weeks now that she molted. And she hasn't really eaten anything so far, but sometimes it takes a while for them, so I'll just wait. Eivik is doing fine. Eozor Tlasi is doing extremely fine. And I think a couple days ago, I was brushing against something here on the sideboard, and she started drumming actually to me. So I'm probably gonna see if I can find a male for her. Probably next year, because it's now way too cold. But probably next year in the spring, I'm gonna try start breeding her. Yeah, little Aavix, Apuperias actually started webbing like crazy in the new enclosures. As you can see, this one made a really interesting tube web. I have a little water dish here, a new one, because the first one, she webbed over. It's right under here, the initial water dish. So, yeah, she's in pre-molt. This is the Homoeomma male that molted. I think he needs one more molt before he's mature. Maybe two, I'm not sure. Can't see any hooks yet. No bulbous pedipalps. So he's not yet mature, but we'll see. Probably gonna sell him off next year. That's a little GBB male. It's pre-molt. The other one is two. Both brachies actually retreated now as well into their burrows. I'm guessing it's because of the time of the year, because, you know, it's winter. And yeah, what else do we have here? I'm waiting for this little guy to mold, actually, my C. fimbriatus. As you can see from this one, this webs like crazy now. He's down there. Don't know if you can see him, don't know. Well, the other one is not really webbing at all. Just this little corner here. Little Pokey started to redecorate its enclosure a little bit. Nothing else. And I got these little, don't know if you can see them. These are Epocarima Tlasi slings I got from Spider Factory WSF from Catron. And very tiny, even tinier than my E-species red, which are these. But yeah, they have not yet molted either so far, so I don't know. What is pretty nice, I don't know if I can show her to you. I'm pretty sure by now that it's a female, but my E-marinas, actually, yeah, I need to rehouse this one again pretty soon, because she's outgrowing her enclosure already again. It's insane. Yeah, well, aside those two molts that I mentioned, the geniculata and the Homoeomma male, I have nothing to report as of now. So I just thought I'd make a short update. There will be a video shortly, probably sometime next week, I don't know. I haven't yet found the time. Regarding stuff that new tea keepers actually get worried about regarding their teas, you know, like, what are these ricey looking things that are in the enclosure in the water dish? Are those eggs? Well, no, it's poop, mostly. Well, anyways, you guys have a good one, and yeah, see ya.